So we see that the transistor is a switch. So we've seen in the last video where we've got some kind of current flowing this way, or could be going up also, but in this case, because of the orientation here, it's going down, and is controlled by the voltage on the base. So if you put a voltage on the base, it opens up this switch and current flows. If you don't put a voltage on the base, it doesn't open the switch and current does not flow. We're going to come back to a slightly more general view of how the transistor works in a minute. There is some information on this slide and this slide with there's some Java applet on it, which actually explains a bit about how this kind of an idea works. This is what's shown on this slide is a different kind of a transistor. This is a field effect transistor. These are actually better for a lot of devices that we would like to build logical devices and so forth. And in this case, rather than a emitter, base, and collector, they have a source, a drain, and a gate. And when the voltage, you can see there's no voltage on the gate here, and there's a voltage on the gate here. When you put a voltage on the gate, you can see there becomes this connection between the source and the drain, and so you get flows from one to the other. And so it really works in a similar way, but what's actually happening in a transistor is that in a bipolar junction transistor, you're creating current carriers when you put the voltage on the base. You can do the same thing with a phototransistor where you illuminate the base with light and you end up getting extra current and it basically opens the switch up. So you can open the switch up with light or with a voltage on the base. But in any case, it's a switch that in the case of the bipolar junction transistor, controls current from the collector to the emitter. There's really two kinds of transistors. The ones that we're going to be using are called NPNs. And we'll understand that a little bit better when we get to experiment 8 and talk about diodes. But for right now, they're just going to be different names and represent current flowing in different directions. So when we put the So we're going to be primarily dealing with the transistors on the right, the NPNs, which gives us current flowing in the downward direction. If we wanted current flowing in the upward direction, we end up with a transistor with the little arrow going in the other direction, and it has to do with the way the transistor is built. There are three characteristic regions for the transistor. There's so-called cutoff region where there's not enough voltage at B for the trans let's just say we say the transistor to turn on. It's really a couple of diodes, but for our purposes we're just going to worry about it as a transistor. In the saturated region we have when the voltage at on the base exceeds something like 0.7 volts, then the switch will turn on and current will flow as much as it possibly can. There is a region in between called the active region where the collector current, that is that current flowing vertically, is some number beta times the base current. And that's where the gain of the transistor actually comes from. Typical numbers are like 170 or 200 or something like that. So let's actually see what happens then, and just very qualitatively. Okay, so we're back to this picture, and as I said previously, as long as this base voltage is high enough, and we've seen it written down in one of the slides, it has to be greater than 0.7 volts, then current will flow from the top to the bottom. And that's for the When you turn the thing on totally, it's not on at all, no current will flow. And then there is an intermediate region called the active region where you have an intermediate voltage on the base. And this little gap here begins to open up. And the gap width would be proportional to the voltage, and the current is a function of the gap width. And so you end up with the current being directly connected to the base current.